everyone. I'm SEU President Kent Ingle, and you're watching SEU Now, our weekly update show where we keep you informed and educated on everything happening right now on the campus of Southeastern University. And today we're going to be talking about our brand new, very exciting partnership with SEU and the National Latino Evangelical Coalition. Under this new partnership, our Hispanic Leadership Center will be renamed after Adolfo Carrión Sr., who was the superintendent of the Spanish Eastern District of the Assemblies of God for nearly 40 years, an amazing leader, and just being grateful to have his namesake on the future initiatives. And here to discuss the details of this exciting new chapter is the founder of the coalition and the SEU, our SEU board member, Reverend Dr. Gabriel Salguero, Chief Executive Officer of Metro Futures LLC, and also Adolfo Carrión Jr. and Dean of the Barnett College of Ministry and Theology, Nick Wallsteadt. Welcome all of you to the show. It's so great to have you here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for doing this. Thanks.
And before we get into our conversation, as you know, what we do on SEU Now, we always fill you in on the top three things that you should be aware of happening here on the campus this week. First of all, this Friday, September 17th, our Humanities Department will be hosting our annual celebration of Constitution Day. The event will be held in room A210 of the Education Building from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Former U.S. Congressman Dennis Ross will be speaking on the topic, Why the Constitution Requires Us and Our Faith to Survive. It's going to be a great event. The event is free. All are welcome. And this is a discussion that you definitely don't want to miss in light of all the circumstances that are going on in our world today. Secondly, our Fire football team will be having their first official home game this Saturday, September 18th at Victory Field, 7 p.m. Fire will take on Thomas More University for an intense matchup. So come on out, show your school spirit, a lot of tailgating, all the good stuff. So come out and, of course, go Fire for the big win this Saturday. And then number three, lastly, I'd like to remind you of our word of the year, a time to sow. Make sure that all of you keep in mind our lives are like spiritual gardens, and the seeds that we plant can either help us thrive or can be harmful to the calling that God has placed on each and every one of our lives. So I want to make sure that you are encouraged to be intentional in maintaining the garden of your life and take some time this week to think about what kind of seeds you're planting in your life and where they might lead you as you continue to grow in your calling and grow in your relationship with the Lord. Well, again, let's get started today. Gabriel, can you begin by telling us a little bit more about the partnership now between SEU and the National Latino Evangelical Coalition? And why is this so significant for both SEU and NALEC?
Well, first, this conversation started about 18 months ago when we were connected with SEU and Dr. Wallsteadt and I had some coffee, good, strong Latino coffee. And we started dreaming together about the growing edge of Pentecostalism in America is Hispanic. Yeah. There's over 9 million Latino evangelicals living in the United States. There's 60 plus million Latinos living in the United States. We're actually the second most populous Latino nation in the world, right? So there are more Hispanics in the U.S. than, let's say, Colombia and Ecuador combined. And so it's significant that is a growing edge of mission and education. And the Latino church is the fastest growing segment of the Assemblies of God in the United States. And so we started talking about how do we empower Latino pastors and clergies and students and congregations to better serve their community. And out of that came this agreement and this memorandum of understanding to launch this partnership. And we said the best day to do it is the first day of Hispanic Heritage Month,
Absolutely.
Which is today.
Today
is the first day of Hispanic Heritage Month. And we started talking about, in addition to sites and partnerships and trainings and lectures and publications, what the center might look like. And you'll hear a little more about the namesake of that. And so we are very excited. We know that partnership with SEU is significant. You are the fastest growing Assemblies of God university in the country. You are over 20% Hispanic population and growing. And you're in Florida.
Yes,
and so,
yes.
So all of those things, I think, came together for this partnership.
Yeah. Wow. Tell us a little bit about NaLEC and the vision and the mission and why it does flow so well with our commitment to provide educational stewardship and leadership development.
Look, NaLEC, as you know, we are similar in that we have similar core values. We're evangelical. I'm an Assemblies of God pastor. I serve on the board. But our commitment to empower indigenous leadership, women and men who are committed to the local context, to its flourishing, to its growth, to its health. And SEU has that track record. Yeah. The Leadership Center is not new. I think we're in the second decade of the 20th century, so we're reimagining how to expand it. Yes. You, for a long time, have committed. You've had Hispanic board members. And one of the things we've always said is a empowered leadership is an empowered community. Mm-hmm. An educated leadership leads to healthy communities. And so that's the perfect synergy. You all have a history of great education. You second to none. You have nothing to envy anyone. And you have a commitment to Hispanic empowerment. Yeah. In addition, we bring something to the table, our history of advocacy, our history of empowerment, our history of long connections to the Latino community. And so those nexus are what I think made this a Kairos moment for today.
Yeah, and we're excited about this partnership. And I want to ask our dean of the Barnett College, Nick, to talk a little bit about how this partnership does benefit Southeastern in so many ways as we work to reach. I mean, our heart is to really empower the next generation of Hispanic and Latino students and in the calling that God has placed upon their lives, because they are going to be tremendous solutions to a lot of the issues and challenges that we're facing in this world. And God is raising them up, empowering them, putting a divine call upon their lives to have a huge impact. So talk to us a little bit about that.
Yeah, thanks, Dr. Ingle. Like Dr. Salguero, you said a second ago, you know, this isn't a new initiative for us, but it's so exciting to envision what this next iteration is going to look like. I think where the Lord has positioned SEU in this season, where we find ourselves, is simply coming alongside the local church. Mm-hmm. And what this will mean, though, this next generation and iteration, as we partner with NaLEC now, will be an opportunity to do that in a more focused way, specifically with Latino-led churches. I think about, for our student body, you mentioned it a second ago, we're 20%, approximately 20%, a little over, of Latino, made up of Hispanic and Latino students. And in that, I think this is going to be an opportunity for who we're partnered with church-wise to represent that diversity as well. And so thrilled for what an honor for our college to be able just to have such an incredible partner in this way.
And let's talk about who we're naming this amazing center out of. Gabriel, share with us about the significance behind the person that we're naming.
When we met, and we've had multiple conversations in your office and side conversations after board meetings, thought, what person really incarnates the very best of servant leadership in Latino Pentecostalism? Yeah. And one of our great pioneers, Adolfo Carrión, Sr., who was superintendent for almost 40 years of the Spanish Eastern District. He founded the Florida Multicultural District. Wow. He founded the Puerto Rico District of the Assemblies of God. Wow. He was a founder of Christian radio stations and several parachurch organizations. And so he was really an apostolic leader in the biblical sense of the word. Under his leadership, they grew from over 37 churches to over 300 churches. Wow. And he was pro-education. I mean, he understood the value of an education, both for, and not just pastors, right? He thought that vocation could be lawyers and judges, and SEU has that comprehensive understanding that we're not just training pastors. SEU has nursing and education and so many, and she understood that for us to do our contribution as the Latino Pentecostal Church. And so Adolfo Carrión Sr. was also listed as one of the 100 distinguished leaders during the centennial of the Assemblies of God. He was one of the prominent leaders to be listed. And so we thought, what other name can engender and promote the example we want to see in the present and emerging generations of Latina and Latino Pentecostals?
Amazing. And we have the high honor of having Adolfo Carrión Jr. with us today. And tell us, Adolfo, tell us a little bit about your father's legacy and what does, you know, renaming our center in his honor mean to you and to your family?
Well, Doc, first of all, thank you. Thank you to Dr. Salguero and his leadership in this initiative and all of you working together. It's a great honor for our family. I have to tell you, when I walked in this morning and I saw that large sign that said, you know, Carrión Leadership Center, you know, I thought about my dad, who was, and I, as we were driving from the airport, he was sharing that, I was sharing this with Gabriel. It was all about service to him. Mm-hmm. You know, he came to New York City from Puerto Rico in the 1950s. He was a Catholic kid. He grew up Catholic. Everybody was Catholic in Puerto Rico. He walked into a church on the Lower East Side and never left. And it was an AG church. It was the Sea of Galilee.
Mar de Galilea.
Yeah, right in the Lower East Side in a Jewish neighborhood. One of his best friends was a New York City rabbi down the street.
Wow.
A real New York story. He got involved right away and quickly became a leader, and within a decade was the pastor of the church. And, you know, the folks who were part of this growing demographic in evangelicalism and in urban centers, you know, they saw that he was just a natural leader. He was a natural servant. And he became district presbyter and then went on to become the superintendent of the Spanish Eastern District Council of the Assemblies of God. Wow. And I still remember as a kid traveling all over the Northeast with him to new churches in cities that had been untapped, unseen, where there was new growth of Latino Hispanic population, you know, workforce is changing, the old industrial cities experiencing their shifts, and what needed to happen, right?
Yeah.
We needed to reach those people. We needed to root them in those cities and build institutions. And, you know, Dad's approach was also always very holistic.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, you mentioned the pioneering district in South Florida and the pioneering district in Puerto Rico and in the Dominican Republic and even in Mexico. But he also did something else, which, you know, to me, I grew up as a teenager working there, which was a 100-acre camp in upstate New York in the Catskill Mountains. And he, as the superintendent, understood that all these folks who are in urban places needed a retreat. They needed a place. They needed fresh air. The kids needed to go camping. They needed to learn about nature. They needed to learn about leadership. One of the things that I experienced was Royal Rangerism and being a Royal Ranger,
right?
You know, and I think we probably are all graduates of, you know, veterans, I should say. but he 115 acres right in the middle of beautiful Catskill Mountains that then became a retreat, that then became a place for the conventions for the Spanish Eastern District Council. And even to this day, I go back there, you know, as a visitor. Having you all given the premier position you're in as a university and as an education leader, to send this signal to the community and to the evangelical community and to the AG community and to the larger community and to the Latino community, that this Puerto Rican kid who came to New York had a tremendous impact on so many people and had a ripple effect on building communities that is really immeasurable.
Yeah.
You know, and to have a young Latino and a young student here say, oh, that's a name I can identify with.
Right.
I can be that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I can aspire. I think you're doing something tremendous. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. And I want to ask Dean Nick here, who has just recently stepped into that role, and we're grateful for your leadership and what you are going to bring to the Barnett College of Ministry and Theology. But talk talk to our audience a little bit about Adolfo Carrión Sr.'s Hispanic Leadership Center. What we hope to see happen in the years to come.
Yeah, man, that's a question that carries with it a lot of dreams, a lot that, quite frankly, we're going to have to rely on Dr. Salguero and all that NaLEC is to help understand what's the best way to do that. I think when I think of what we do in education at Southeastern, specifically in the ministry landscape, but really broadly at the university, so much of education is about stewardship. It's about stewarding what God's placed in your heart, the abilities he's given you. This is something Dr. Ingle says all the time. I look at that lens, stewarding our students' lives and then also stewarding our relationships. And I don't know if we've had a greater honor in stewarding this moment than Adolfo Carrión Sr., that name, that legacy, what that carries with it. So I think as we dream about what's this going to look like, of course, tangibly speaking, it's probably going to look like a new network of partnerships at the local church level, making education affordable, accessible, pushing it that direction, having market-driven, industry-facing, and industry-formed degree programs. What are the things that we need to do even beyond ministry, in technology, in STEM, in business and education, those things? But I would say the vision, real broadly speaking, is to steward the season well, is to say, who's the next Adolfo Carrión Sr. and Jr.? Who's that? Maybe they're here at our central campus in Lakeland, but maybe they're at one of our partnerships around the country. Maybe they're a student who hasn't even moved here yet.
Yeah.
And what legacy are they going to have access to tap into?
Yeah. No, that's great. And I do want to ask you a final question before we close our time together. Why is this center so relevant, especially with what's going on in our nation right now?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it's crucial that for what we do at SEU, and especially for the really for the College of Ministry, that our makeup in who we are as a college, in our student base, it reflects not only the national landscape, but really the kingdom of God.
Right.
And the kingdom of God is so diverse, and so I think for this particular moment, we would never intentionally be myopic in our engagement. That's never been a focus or intention. In fact, we currently work with all kinds of churches and all kinds of places. But, man, what an opportunity to elevate our awareness for in the national conversation to say Southeastern is going to not only adopt this name and this center, but really what that means is it's going to mean a new platform of leadership. It's going to mean a new platform in many ways for generations to come. So I think it allows our students, who are Gen Z students, to say, hey, as we're envisioning the future, this is what this looks like. We're going to be near the heart of God.
And in terms of stewardship, if you take that, you know, that thought forward, you know, Hispanics are the fastest growing sector of our population.
Right. Absolutely.
It's an investment in the garden in the future.
That's great. And we've got a full day of events, and I'll share a little bit more about those in just a minute. But one of the, you know, we're going to have a press conference, and you're going to be doing a lecture coming up this afternoon talking about the future of the Hispanic church. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, the lecture is really using a taxonomy of Adolfo Carrión Sr.'s leadership for the future. I think sometimes we have to go back to go forward.
Amen.
And so there's a lot of learnings in his kind of what I call apostolic esprit de corps, you know, spirit of the body, that is empowering indigenous leaders, establishing healthy churches, and organizing parachurch and outward-facing organizations for the health of our communities. And so there's a lot that we can learn from his community that speaks to the future of the Hispanic church in America.
Wow.
And what I love about it, Southeastern, is that it understands the church is not just the pastor, but the young student who's pre-law, the young student who's pre-med, the young student who's in STEM, whoever she is or whoever he is. And so you all have a comprehensive look at the basileo to theo, the kingdom of God. And I think that is what the lecture seeks to underscore and highlight.
That's going to be exciting. Well, Adolfo, Gabriel, Nick, thank you for joining us today on SEU Now. And thank everybody that tuned in this morning. It's been a pleasure to have you all on the show. If you'd like to learn more details about the partnership and the renaming of the Hispanic Leadership Center, make sure you head out to the press conference this afternoon at 3 p.m. in the Buena Vida Auditorium. And again, Dr. Salguero will be providing a lecture on the future of the Hispanic Church. Trust me, you do not want to miss it. As usual, keep up with the latest SEU news and updates online. Follow us on social media at SEU University and at Ken _ Ingle. Hope you all have an amazing day and an amazing week. We look forward to connecting with you again on SEU Now. Take care, everybody.